I'm really hesitant to cover this one. Not because it's bad, but because it's not a horror movie. It's a comedy with some over-the-top gore. It's a total switch of the genre. Whereas Bride of Chucky could almost be called a dark comedy, this one's not even that dark. What we get is a family drama. A soap opera, if you will, that's filled with mindless parental bickering. You would think that with the writer of the original Child's Play at the helm, he would give us, well, anything besides this. Now, that's not to say Seed of Chucky, the fifth entry in the Chucky series, is a bad movie. Like Bride, it just depends on how you look at it. With that being said, aside from some funny moments, I can't see old-school Child's Play fans embracing this. Much like the red-headed title character, this is pretty much the red-headed stepchild of the franchise. Yes, even when compared to Bride of Chucky. So after that last movie, where else can the series go, you ask? Well, it starts out with a random British family being killed off by a doll who we assume is Chucky. Is it me, or did someone steal from Halloween? It sure bears a striking resemblance. Of course, everyone in the house is killed off. And look, a shower scene ripped right from Psycho, minus the boobies. We find out that it's a dream sequence. The twist? It was this little deformed thing that was having the dream. Seriously, who designed him and how come he looks nothing like Chucky or Tiffany? What's wrong with his teeth and why did the filmmakers think it would be so funny to have the little spazoid pee his pants? I'm not joking, he does this all throughout the film.
Hey, you're pissing your pants!
So it turns out that the little monkey spank is part of an act called, and I'm not making this up, Sykes and Shitface. I'm not kidding, that's the doll's name when he's introduced. Shitface.
Who the hell are you?
Shitface.
Now what kind of a name is that?
It turns out that Shitface, God that's funny, is an orphan who doesn't know who his real parents are. Gee, I wonder who that could be. I mean, he only has nightmares about killing people. Maybe his dad's OJ. So we switch to the real stars of the movie, Chucky and Tiffany, who are in the process of killing a Santa Claus. Are you effing kidding me? We're really stooping to that level. However, before getting the old slasheroo, he does get bound up with a slinky.
I knew it! You're not real!
We pull back and, surprise, surprise, it's a movie set. Now here's where the movie becomes one big self-reference. Jennifer Tilly, the actress, not a character, is portraying the flesh-and-blood Tiffany in another Chucky movie because her career is going down the crapper. In that sense, maybe this is a biography. But it begs the question, if Jennifer Tilly is playing herself, then is this a sequel or a reimagining? It's kind of like in Wes Craven's New Nightmare where everyone plays themselves and acts like they're everyday normal people. Well, we're dealing with the Seed of Chucky here, which is a direct continuation of the last movie. If you remember, that one ended with a fetus crawling out of a doll's cooch. Fuck it, moving on. So anyway, of course, Miss Tilly is pissed that she can't find any good roles in Hollywood.
Nice tits.
Thank you.
In the meantime, Shitface sees his red-haired dad on television, during an interview of all things, and notices that Chucky has the same Made in Japan tattoo as him. There's one fatal problem with this. How many frickin' dolls do you suppose are made in Japan? The kid escapes from his greasy British handler and FedExes himself to Hollywood. I love how they get around copyright infringement here. DFS, double fast service. Boy, you're really sticking it to the UPS guys, aren't you? Now, the kid's got a pendant that somebody left him, and when he reads the oh-so-familiar incantation, he wakes Mommy and Daddy, and we have a little family reunion.
Where are your mother and father?
Judging from that face, my guess is they're hiding.
Shut up, you asshole.
It's a little funny, and pretty stupid, but not in the least bit scary. In fact, after we see Mr. Sound Guy lose his head, it's just a big family drama. The big dilemma? Because Shitface... Okay, that is getting a little old, but that's what they named him. But because Shitface is not anatomically correct, Chucky and Tiffany can't decide if he's going to be a boy or a girl. And when they try naming him, even the simple act of picking a name is bastardized.
I think I'm going to call you... Glenn.
Glenn? What kind of name is that for a girl? Don't listen to him, honey. From now on, your name is... Glinda.
Pick a name, any name, as long as it's not Shitface. I just want to get away from that joke already. There's even a kind of touching moment when Glenn...
Glinda.
asks his parents why they kill, and Chucky's response comes out so natural.
It's a hobby, really. It helps us relax.
Am I going to be a killer?
Of course. It's been a family tradition for generations.
It's just an everyday activity to the old face-chopping redhead. During a domestic spat, Tiffany makes Chucky promise that they won't kill anymore. Papa disagrees and decides to take Glenn...
Glinda.
...on a little field work.
Up yours, asshole!
Oops, I did it again.
As the body count builds up, Glenn...
Glinda.
...finally decides on a gender and also decides, hey, I want to take up the family business. Now, this scene right here is probably the only scary part in this whole entire movie.
Tiff?
Man, that's creepy. As it turns out, Jennifer Tilly is actually pregnant, and we get to see Tiffany deliver the little hellspawns.
It's a girl.
If you thought the movie was effed up before, boy, are you in for a doozy. She actually delivers a set of twins, which is just so convenient for Tiffany, seeing as how their demonic, freakish kid still can't make up his, or her, mind about what sex he wants to be. So now he's conveniently got two babies whose souls he can possess. Of course, Tiffany wants to possess Jennifer Tilly's body, and Chucky, get this, just decides he'd rather go on living as a possessed psychotic doll. It all ends in yet another ridiculous puppet fist fight where Tiffany decides to leave Chucky and take the kid with her. But Chucky tracks her down and slices her up just before she can transfer her soul into Jennifer Tilly's body. Or so we think. So that's Seed of Chucky in a nutshell. More bizarre and warped than the last one, they took a silly concept and stretched it about as thin as it could go. Dumb self-references.
Oh my god, she's a complete slut.
Dumb pop culture references, over-the-top kills, although this one's kind of cool. And something I never thought I would ever see. Puppet titties. It's a big family drama that forgets. It's supposed to be a horror movie. Now let me reiterate, if you're in the mood for a comedy that takes a well-known slasher icon and turns him into a 90-minute sitcom, then this is for you. Hell, you can practically hear the laughter track.
I'm going to transfer my soul into Jennifer, and you're going to transfer your soul into Redman.
I'm down with that.
We'll ditch these plastic bodies once and for all, and we'll be holding it out of couple.
I have to admit, there were parts I thought were genuinely funny. But if I wanted a comedy, I wouldn't have turned to a horror franchise. And it's nice that the creators understood. You can only take a vengeful killer doll so far before you have to start parodying it at some point. And you could argue that Bride of Chucky successfully did that. But you've heard the phrase, breaking the fourth wall. Well, this one obliterates the fourth wall and gives us something unexpected. Is it entertaining? About as entertaining as a couple of male nude foreigners fighting in a hotel room. Seriously, I'm not re-editing any of this or making it sound dumber than it is. What we have here is what we get, folks. I'm not keen on remakes, and in fact, given that trend in the horror genre, I downright loathe them. But Child's Play is a series that could be reinvigorated if you do it right. And in the case of the series, hey... it needs to go back to its gritty, dark roots. I would only recommend this one if you're seriously in need of your Chucky fix, or if you're a Billy Boyd fan.
As a doll, I'm fucking infamous. I'm one of the most notorious slashers in history, and I don't want to give that up. I am Chucky, the killer doll, and I dig it!